SICU number 1 in patients with left ankle arthrodesis on the talocrural joint who is suffering from joint stiffness on the entire back and limitation of motion and probable subtalar OA. How might you need to modify your interventions for this particular patient to follow precautions? I won't provide any intervention that requires much weight bearing and full range of motion, exercises, or movements. If patient needs to progress, I will make sure the progression is gradual and the patient must meet the criteria of progression before leveling up the interventions for fast recovery or healing, and also to follow proper precautions. SICU number 2, what movement is contraindicated for a patient with in situ fixation on humeral neck rupture during the maximum protection phase? What intervention is best for the patient's recovery? My answer is shoulder extension or internal rotation is contraindicated during maximum protection phase. The best intervention is active range of motion, cervical, elbow, wrist, and hand in order to maintain ROM in surrounding joints and to prevent deconditioning. SICU number 3, one of the common complications of TAA or total ankle arthroplasty with a fixed bearing attachment is restricted mobility. What do you think is the contributing factor and explain why? Because of the orthosis applied is fixed bearing, which also means the limb is also fixed and stabilized enough. And this is why the movement is also limited and this results to restricted mobility. SICU number 4, in skeletal traction on the left LE, fracture on the left femur and pelvic fracture, patient is bedbound, what precaution should be followed? Provide 2. Number 1, the pull should always be in line with the extremity. Number 2, due to the risk of injury to the peroneal nerve, it is recommended to place the traction pin from lateral to medial. So SICU number 5, post-op TAA cemented approach, maximum protection phase, weight-bearing status training to 50% PWD from no weight-bearing phase, 3 weeks post-op in progressing to moderate protection phase, what criteria should the patient achieve and why? Okay, so number 1, patient wound must be almost completely healed or completely healed and also determined by surgeon with approval. Number 2, patient can weight bear to the affected side approximately 30 to 50% of the weight.